Good day, this is Teacher Riza, and this is our lesson for Module 3, Operations and Functions in General Mathematics. And our learning competency is perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and composition of function. And our objectives for these lessons are defines operation on functions, identify the different operations on functions, perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and composition of function. Suppose we have two given functions here, f of x is equal to 3x plus 1 and g of x is equal to 2x. Finding the sum of these two functions means we're going to add 3x plus 1 plus 2x. And that is 3x plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 5x plus 1. Finding the difference means we're going to subtract 3x plus 1 minus 2x. That is 3x minus 2x plus 1 is equal to x plus 1. And finding the quotient means we're going to multiply 3x plus 1 times 2x. That is 3x times 2x plus 1 times 2x is equal to 6x squared plus 2x. And finding the quotient, that is 3x plus 1 over 2x. By the definition, let f and g be functions. So finding the sum of f and g means f plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. And finding the difference of f and g means we're going to subtract f minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. And finding the product of f of and g, that is f times g of x is equal to f of x times g of x, and finding the quotient of f and g, that is f divided by g of x is equal to f of x divided by g of x. Then for composition of function, f, the small circle there, is composed, f composed of g of x, or we can write that into parentheses. Example, given the function f of x is equal to x plus 5 and g of x is equal to 2x minus 1 and h of x is equal to 2x squared plus 9x minus 5, we're going to find f plus g of x, which is f of x plus g of x, that is by the definition of addition of function. Then next, we're going to replace f of x and g of x by the given values. That is f of x is equal to x plus 5 and g of x is equal to 2x minus 1. Then after that, we're going to combine like term. That is 3x plus 2x is equal to 3x. Then 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. Then for subtraction, f minus g of x is equal to f of x minus g of x. That is the definition of subtraction of functions. Then replace f of x and g of x by the given values. That is f of x equal to x plus 5, then g of x is equal to 2x minus 1. So distribute the negative sign, that is x plus 5, negative times 2x is negative 2x, then negative times negative 1 is equal to positive 1. Then after that, combine like terms. So we have now x minus 2x is equal to negative x, then 5 plus 1 is equal to x. So therefore, the difference is negative x plus 6, and the sum is 3x plus 4. Then for multiplication, that is f times g of x means f of x times g of x. That is the definition of multiplication of functions. Then replace f of x, which is x plus 5, and g of x is equal to 2x minus 5. Then multiply the binomials using the distributive property. So that's x times 2x minus 1, then multiply 5 to 2x minus 1. That is x times 2x is equal to x squared, then x times negative 1 is equal to negative x, and 5 times 2x is equal to 10x, and 5 times negative 1 is equal to negative 5. And combine like terms, we have 2x squared, negative x plus 10x is equal to 9x minus 5. Then for division, that is h divided by g of x, or that is h of x divided by g of x, by the definition of division of function. Then replace h of x by 2x squared plus 9x minus 5, and g of x by 2x minus 5. minus 1. Since the numerator is factor of bus, we're going to factor the numerator. And the factor is to x plus 5 times 2x minus 1. Since we have a common term, so we're going to cancel 2x minus 1. So therefore, the quotient is x plus 5. Another example is f plus g of 3. For this time, our x is 3. So that means we're going to find f of 3 plus g of 3. Then, we're going now to find f of 3 using f of x is equal to x plus 5 by substituting x by 3. So that's 3 plus 5, which is equal to 8. Then for g of x, we're going to use 2x minus 1. Then change x by 3. So that's 2 times 3 minus 1. So which is equal to 5. Since we're finding for the sum, we're going to add 8 plus 5, which is equal to 13. And we have an alternative solution for that. That is finding the sum of f and g, that is x plus 5 plus 2x minus 1, that is equal to 3x plus 4. Then change x by 3, that is f plus g of 3. So that's 3 times 3 is equal to 9 plus 4, which is also equal to 13. So that's the alternative solution. Then another example is f minus g of 3 is equal to function of 3 minus g of 3. So first, we're going to find f of x, which is f of 3 is equal to 8. Then for g of x, we're in g of 3 is equal to 5. Since we are finding the difference, we're going to subtract 8 minus 5, which is equal to 3. And alternative solution for this, we're going to find the difference of f minus g of x, that is x plus 5 minus 2x minus 1, which is equal to negative x plus 6. Since x is equal to 3, so we're going to find f of minus g of 3, that is changing x by by 3, so we have negative 3 plus 6 equal to positive 3. Then we have f times g of 3 is equal to f of 3 minus g of 3, wherein our answer for f of 3 while ago is 8, and for g of 3 we have 5. So that means we're going to multiply function of 3 minus g of 3, that 8 times 5, which is equal to 40. Then for function composition is the process of obtaining composite function, wherein composite function is denoted by f, the small circle, means or read as composed, f composed of g of x, which is also defined as f composed of g of x, or we can also use, aside from the small circle, parenthesis inside, so that is also read as f composed of g of x. Composition of function is putting a function inside another function. So for example, we have given h of x is equal to x plus 2 and f of x is equal to 3x minus 5. For h of x plus 2, we're going to input that into f of 3x minus 5, means we're going to substitute x plus 2 in x of 3x minus 5. So we're going to change x by x plus 2, so that's 3 times x plus 2 minus 5 is equal to 3x plus 6 minus 5. So therefore, f composed of h of x is equal to 3x plus 1. Another example is f composed of g of x equal to f composed of g of x, wherein g of x is equal to x minus 5, so that will be the domain. So using f of x equal to 3x plus 2, we're going to change x by x minus 5. So that's 3 times x minus 5 plus 2. So we have 3 times x is 3x, then 3 times negative 5 is equal to negative 15 plus 2. So that's 3x minus 13. And then for g composed of f of x is equal to g composed of f of x. So we're in our f of x inside the parentheses is equal to 3x plus 2. So we're going now to find g, that is 3x plus 2. So change x by 3x plus 2 minus 5. So we have now g of x is using g of x equal to 3x minus 3. So we're going to find now the value of g of x, that's 3x minus 3. For g composed of f of 4 is equal to g composed of f of 4. To evaluate composition of function, always start with the inside function from right to left. In this case, we first evaluated f of 4 and then substituted the resulted value to g of x. For example, we have f of x is equal to 3x plus 2. So we're going to input 4 inside 3x plus 2 means we're going to change x by 4, so that's 3 times 4 plus 2. And that is equal now to 14. So we're going to input now 14 to g of x minus 5. So that means we're going to change x by 14 minus 5 is equal now to 9. So therefore, g composed of f of 4 is equal to 9. So that is g composed of f of 4. So using f of 4, so we have 3x plus 2. Then changing x by 4, so it's equal to 14. Then using g of f of x, wherein our f of 4 is equal to 14. So that is changing x by 14. 14 minus 5 is also equal to 9. So the answer is equal to 9. Then for this time, we're going to find f composed of g of negative 2. That is, using g of negative 2, that is x minus 5. So we're going to change x by negative 2. Negative 2 minus 7 is equal, minus 2 is equal to negative 7. Then for f composed of g of negative 2, wherein g of negative 2 is equal to negative 7. So we're going to use 3x plus 2, change x by negative 7. So that's 3 times negative 7 plus 2 is equal to negative 21 plus 2, which is equal to negative 19. So the answer is negative 19. So that's all for your activity 1.3. You're going to answer module 3, solve and explain the assessment given in pages 15 to 16. So before we end, let me share these operations in real-life quotations. Math may not teach us how to add love or subtract hate, but it gives us hope that every problem has a solution. And for life to be meaningful, add little sacrifice, subtract anger and hatred, multiply friends and divide love for everyone to share. And that's all. Please always keep safe. Please don't forget to subscribe. Have a nice day. Thank you.